Hello world travelers and welcome to GeoQ, an app like no other. I'm one of your hosts, Chase.
And my name is Sunny. We've been trotting the globe together for some time now. That's what led us to develop GeoQ.
Yep, since we launched the GeoQ app, our global quest has gone to a whole new level.
It's so cool. GeoQ gives us the green light to travel and it drops us in a completely new and exciting location. Then you get to help us figure out where we are.
Because we never know where we're going until we get there. Once we land, you'll play a game to figure out our location and then hunt for a souvenir. And I love souvenirs because it's like you get to take a little piece of somewhere with you.
That's right, and each time you help us find a souvenir, it unlocks a clue about our next quest. Now, before we jump right into all that our GeoQ app has to offer, we need to fill you in on some of our greatest travel hacks.
And in case you don't know what a travel hack is, it's a helpful tip or trick that can help you when you're on the go.
All right, to find out today's travel hack, it's time to play a game, and this one is called What's in the Suitcase?
You'll see a suitcase with the top five items that you can't forget on a trip, but you'll only be able to see their shadows.
Guess what they are before the timer runs out to hear today's travel hack. Today's travel hack is to pack what's important. Snacks are definitely at the top of the list for me, especially candy.
Sounds like your toothbrush should be at the top of that list too. For me, I can't leave home without Mr. Fluffaluffagus.
I don't know how you fit that thing in your suitcase every time. Now, we do have one more travel hack before we get going today.
We sure do. This one's for when you're getting ready to go on a long plane ride. You gotta make sure you have some tunes queued up to help the time go by.
And I've got one fired up and ready to kick us off. Everyone, stand up and let's sing this together.
My shepherd, my healer, my
Bible. Now I'm ready to wander.
Me too. Let's see where GOQ takes us today.
Grab your suitcase, my friend. It's time to go. But where are we?
We need you to help us figure it out by playing this next game.
Let's play this or that. Listen out for a question. If you think the answer is on this side of the screen, wave your arms this way. And if you think the answer is on that side of the screen, wave your arms that way. Ready? Here we go. Question 1. What did Sonny and Chase's location look like? The rainforest or the desert? Question 2. What is the most popular sport in this country? Question 3. Which famous statue is in this place? Now that you know these three things about Sonny and Chase's location, what country do you think they're in? Brazil or Egypt? Location confirmed.
Yes, we're in Brazil. Good job, GeoQuesters.
Good thing I packed my rain boots. I can't wait to find out more about this place.
Hey there, GeoQuesters. The bestest of the questest. I'm Juan Durown, and I'm here to confirm where you've wandered off to. You are, in fact, in Brazil. You guessed it, or maybe you just got lucky and stumbled into a rainforest. Either way, you are here. Welcome, and bem-vinda, as they would say here in Portuguese. That's the official language of Brazil. Ah, Brazil. Can you smell it? The rain is in the air. Oh, you didn't bring your umbrella. Don't you worry, we've got you covered. Covered with fun facts, it is. Check it out. Did you know that 60% of the Amazon rainforest is here in Brazil? Yeah, that's right, more than half. There are also around 2,500 airports here. Talk about a lot of rain delays.
Yes, all flights have been delayed until further notice.
Well, when folks aren't flying up in the rainy skies, they're probably on the ground running around shouting, "Go!" Soccer, or football, as they call it here, is the most popular sport in Brazil. Their national team is top of the tops, one of the best in the world, having won the World Cup 5 times. That's right, 5 times. That's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's like one per finger. That is a lot of wins. Whoa, sounds like the rain is back in the forecast. I hope those footballers have an indoor field. The rain shouldn't be surprising, though. It rains so much here, I guess that's where they got the idea to call their forest a rainforest. It's funny. Brazil can get up to 80 inches of rain each year. 80 inches. That stacks as high as LeBron James. Oh, you're probably wondering why you're here in Brazil and what souvenir you should be looking for. Great question, and the answer will be found at coordinates 23 degrees, 32, 1.6 south northwest, south north. You know what? Come think of it, I may not be the best at coordinates, but no worries though, because they're already uploaded onto your GOQ dashboard. Need more than just some numbers and letters? Fear not, you know me, I'm Juan, your best questie for life. So here are a few hints. What you're looking for sounds like the rainforest. You could make it yourself with a tree and some beans, and once you find it, you could join a band. Now, those coordinates have been uploaded into GeoQ. Make sure you check back once you found the souvenir.
One time, I wanted to bring a kangaroo back as a souvenir from Australia, but they wouldn't let me bring him on the plane.
Such a bummer. But that's why we created souvenir badges here in GeoQ. They help us remember where we've been, and when you find them, they unlock our next quest.
All right, keep your eyes on the screen and listen out for us to give you the clues to find this week's souvenir. First up, clue number one, it sounds like the rainforest.
I hear birds and rain and frogs.
Okay, clue number two, you could make it yourself with a tree and some beans.
Ooh, craft time! And don't forget that Juan said once you find it, you could join a band.
Yes, that's clue number three. Okay, you have a few more seconds to find it if you haven't already. Yell out what you think it is.
It was a rain stick!
Great work, GeoQ users. Now that you found today's souvenir, let's see what Juan's got to say.
Aw, yeah, you found it. Oh yeah, you found it. You found the rain stick. Way to go, Questinators. Oh, listen to that. Music to my ears. I mean, nothing really says I took a trip to the rainforest like a rain stick. Better souvenir than a tree shirt. Am I right? Tree shirt? You know, just the idea of thousands of drops of water just randomly falling from the sky makes me ask the question, who's in charge of all this? The rain, the trees, the sky? When you really start to think about all the awesome things in this great big world, there has to be someone behind it all. Well, spoiler alert, there is. Yep, real talk, and I'm about to name drop right here. You ready for this? God, the main man with the mana, the OG of the OT, the creator of creation. And as you get to know more, you find out there are so many names for him in the Bible. But you know, what really is in a name? Well, pretty much everything, because everybody's name helps us know more about them, including who God is. One of the names of God is Lord. Yeah, Lord. Take that in for a minute. That means he is all powerful and in control of everything in this world, including each of us. Talk about being large and in charge. We know God is in control because he made it all, just by speaking it into existence. But back then, there were no shopping centers to buy glue sticks or pipe cleaners or glitter. Nope. God made everything on his own, and he did it without any supplies. Zero. Zilch. Nada. That's right. There was no universe, no sun or moon before time began. There was just big, empty space. Hello? Anybody out there? But God didn't want to just leave it like this, so he got to work. God said, "Let there be light." And as soon as he did, light appeared, separating the day from the night. You'd think that this would be his brightest idea, but God was just getting warmed up. Now it was time for the good stuff. God then made the sky in all the colors we see. Well, even chartreuse. The land and ocean came next. We've got mountains, streams, islands, and the rainforest. God didn't stop there though. No way, Jose. Next came all sorts of different plants, like banana trees and orchids. And then animals like the great white shark and the monkey. Haven't you always wanted a monkey? It's a monkey. And for the grand finale, drum roll please. Created in God's own image, God created us, humans. God started with one man named Adam, and then he created a woman named Eve. Then he told them to take care of every living thing. It was a pretty busy week for God, but when he had finished creating everything, he thought it was all good, and so he rested. Huh, I guess I would have done the same thing. I wanted you to locate the rain stick as a reminder that God created everything, that he is in total control and is Lord over all, because God is my Lord. Well, that's all we have for you here in Brazil, but don't you worry, we aren't resting from no questing anytime soon. So I'll see you all next time.
incredible. Our time in Brazil has taught me so much about who God is. This rain stick badge is going to help us always remember that God is my Lord. Because every time I see it, I can remember that just like God created the rainforest and is in complete control of it, He is in complete control of my life too.
Everyone get quiet and listen with us. The next time you hear the rain falling from the sky, remember God is in control. He created everything and He is Lord.
Come on, fellow questers, say this after me.
God is
my Lord.
My Lord.
That's exactly right. And earning this week's souvenir badge unlocks a clue about our next quest.
The population in the next country we're visiting is 5% human and the rest is all animals.
Whoa, is there really a place like that?
Well, I guess we'll find out soon.
In the meantime, want to sing another one of our travel songs?
Yes, stand up and let's sing together. I hope you've had as much fun on our app as we have.
That's all the time we have to play today, so let's all bow our heads, close our eyes, and pray together.
Hey God, thank you for showing us more about who you are. We're so thankful that you are our Lord. Thank you for loving us and being in total control of our lives. Help us remember that we can talk to you about everything because there's nothing too hard for you. We love you. Amen.
See you all next week. Thank you.